Welcome everybody, this is Mr. Fugu, and you are watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. Today we will be doing a small tutorial for MongoDB with MapReduce. As always, the code will be linked in the description below. The objective will be to give a basic idea of what MapReduce is, some of its use cases, create a few examples with explanations, and show, for instance, when aggregation might be used in place of MapReduce. So, in general, MapReduce is used for parallel computing for large data sets where you're processing the data either in a file system or a database where the file system is taking unstructured data. The general idea of map takes in your local data and creates a temp file and makes a single copy of the data to store it. You have a shuffle step where you're redistributing the data, and then you're reducing by processing the data by keys in parallel because you're creating key value pairs. Now, you are writing these functions in JavaScript, so just take that into consideration. Okay. So the map, just think of that as mapping values, multiple values to one key. All right. Then we will be using what's called an emit function with our key value pairs. And then you have what will be a this dot. And that is to work with whatever document you want to process for MapReduce. And then just think of, again, the reduce where you're taking a single key and mapping it to a list of values. Okay, so some use cases in the real world. You can use this for graph theory, classification, inverted indexes, machine learning, document clustering are some of the examples. Okay, and then here's something that is kind of overlooked, but if you're doing a reduce function and you're calling it more than once, then you need to take into consideration that it needs to be associative, idempotent, and commutative. Okay, so from the data last time, we have this where I created a database where I'm saying I'm a recruiter and I have candidates, and these candidates have this information, where it's a first name, last name, what their skills are, what state they live in, their specialty, their experience level, are they willing to relocate? Okay? The first example today we will do is assume that your boss tells you, hey, let's find all of the candidates based on each state and let's count them. All right? And your boss wants you to get more candidates for your database. You know, they want you to generate more revenue and find out what states are basically lacking. So we need to create a variable, and here I'm calling it map func. You could call it whatever you want to call it. All right. So we're taking our map func and saying, all right, function, open parentheses because we're not calling anything in there. And then we're using our emit that I mentioned, and then this dot candidate dot state. So I'm saying, this is what I'm calling. So I'm calling the state and I'm counting that. So we plug that in for our map function. Then to reduce, we're taking our states and our value that we're counting, and we're iterating through that through the length here of it, where we increment our count and return the values. Okay, so we can plug that in here. So let's do this. So we have basically a clean slate to look at. And then, so you can see what's going on here. Oh, this is from something else I was playing with. Okay. So let's take this, make sure it's copied, paste it in. Okay. So there. Now we have our, MapReduce function. Okay, so now we have to take our reduce function that I just explained. We plug that in, If I could get this stupid thing to copy. Perfect. Then we have to call MapReduce. So what happens is you take your db.recruiter clients, which is our collection, and you say MapReduce. And inside MapReduce, you have to tell it what you are mapping. So you do your map function, your reduce function, and then out is a file that I'm creating, which are the skills by state. You could also have a different alternative here, which is inline equals true or one, which would mean you're printing all your output directly. But if you have a large data set, you don't want to do that, okay? So we do that and we wait. Perfect. So we took in 500 of our clients, we emitted 500 and we reduced it to 50, which is the number of states, and our output is our states. And okay, true. Now, we're going to say, let's do this. So we're going to now call what I just named this here. So we do that, and then we have our count. So we say db dot, and then the name of the function, the file that I just created, fine, and then I just wanted a prettier format. So then we say, okay, Alaska has 10 people in the database. California has 11, Florida has 11, etc. Fine. Well, let's sort these values and find out where we need to adjust our database. So basically, I said sort equals 1, where it's ascending, whereas if it was negative 1, it's descending order. So it looks like Vermont, South Dakota, Virginia, New Hampshire, and Indiana, and a few others less than 10. So we'll just say these four right here are basically where we need to bump our values up and get some more clients into our database. Okay? Then, for the example two, assume that your boss is interested in what frequency of all skills. Okay? So this, let's see what that really looks like. So I'm taking the skills, and the skills are a list of values. All right? So I do this dot candidate dot skills because it's nested, and then I'm iterating through that, and I'm emitting the skill, and I'm going to count those. Okay? So we do that. Then we have a reduce function where we're taking our keys and our values, and we're counting our values, and we're incrementing and returning the count. So that's what's going on here. Then we need to do our db.collection.mapReduce, and then we need to call our functions in that we're looking for again, because we want in the MapReduce to say, all right, this is the map function you're looking for, this is the reduction function you're looking for, and then output will be stored in skills underscore stuff. So we take that. We'll wait for it to calculate. Cool. So we took in 500 entries, and then this looks kind of strange, but remember it was a list of values, and each list had different values from 1 to 9. So that's why we have 2469. Then we reduced it to 45, and then the output will be 9 because there were up to 9 values. So now we call the output file that we just stored. So db dot and then the file's name, and then call that, and then perfect. So there were 9 skills, and then we counted the number of times that the skills happened. Okay, so assuming that, like, your boss said, what people have what skills, okay, or how often do particular skills come up, you know? So then that's what's going on here, and it looks like it's distributed, you know, fairly evenly, you know, which is interesting. Then I said, okay, what if we wanted to do something else? So if I was looking for the first and last name of somebody and trying to find out are they willing to relocate, well, that's a little bit difficult to do a map reduce, because now how am I going to set this up? Because now I have basically two keys, and then my value is my relocation. Well, map reduce, that might be a little challenging. You could probably do like a string concatenation or something like that to combine the first and last name probably, and then run this. But here, I found it's just better that I do an aggregation where I do a projection and take the first and last name and then create like a temp variable basically saying relocate yes, and then ignore the IDs. So let's see what this looks like. So then here we're saying, okay, first name, last name, and then are they willing to relocate? False, true. Okay, so this person is willing to relocate. This person is willing to relocate. Okay, that's a little bit along what I was looking for, but let's see what else we could do. So what about if they want to relocate, yes or no? Well, then we need to use that OR operator. So we have kind of similar to what we're doing here, but we're expanding onto it with the OR operator for yes and maybes. So then we say, all right, let's do an aggregation where we're projecting our data for the candidate's first and last name. We basically have this new variable name that's taking in to consideration if someone is willing to relocate or not, and printing that out as true. Okay, so we're getting kind of closer. Well, what else do we have? Well, we have this one that I mentioned here. It says it's kind of a weird format, and you're going to see why. So you're doing the same kind of thing and expanding on the last one where you're saying, let's aggregate, let's project, let's take our first and our last name, let's look for the relocation, but now we're doing a conditional statement where we're saying if we have a relocation equal to no, then let's remove that. Well, what's going on here? Otherwise, just append all the other information. Well, this seems like it's going to be kind of funny. What is it removing? Well, it's removing the whole relocation part. So basically, for your eyes, it's pleasing, and you say, okay, yes, maybe, 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 yes, yes, maybe. Okay, cool. And then this is just nothing there. Okay, well, that might be something you want to look at. And then what happens if I just do something really simple and do a match? Okay, well, let's do a match. Oh, yeah, that matched a bunch of things. We matched everything that had yes. So you're matching the whole entire document as long as it had a relocation of yes. So what's the deal here? Basically, if you want to use MapReduce, consider using it in cases where you have a lot of data that can be spread across many machines for parallel computing. That's where it really strives. If you have little data, I would suggest doing other methods. Also, if I'm running something where I'm trying to count values, do an average, things like this, and I could do it with a key value pair, then the map reduce would probably be a good idea. If I have multiple keys and values, I would have to really think about that and would probably just run an aggregate function like I did with these. But as always, like, subscribe, and turn on that notification bell, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.